Have you ever noticed your learner seeming distracted during instruction? You might assign a task and your learners are clearly not paying attention because they are looking around at other stuff. Let's call this barrier too much visual distraction. We always talk about learners needing visuals, but sometimes visuals can be too much for all learners. Students with autism benefit from an environment that has limited visual distractions and has clear boundaries and defined spaces. This provides them with a sense of calming as well as supporting understanding of what happens when in a learning space and what to expect when they are there. We can frame this barrier with the UDL guidelines under multiple means of representation, specifically checkpoint 1.1, offer ways of customizing the display of information. We can customize the display of information in many ways for all learners. We can change text size, reduce or add graphics, use color or increase the contrast between the background and text on a page. In addition to these visual customizations with print, we can also think about it from the lens of autism. There are many ways to reduce visual distractions in your space. According to the Organization for Autism Research, or OAR, there are ways that you can manipulate the physical aspects of your classroom and ways you can place autistic children within the classroom to make them more comfortable without sacrificing your plans for the class in general. This can occur for all students, not just those with autism. Any student who finds the classroom to be visually distracting will benefit from a thoughtfully designed classroom that considers this need. A key benefit of a less visually intense classroom is behavior management. This affords learners and teachers the opportunity to establish the routines and expectations of the classroom, as well as to understand what type of instruction occurs in different parts of the classroom. When the environment distracts learners, it impedes their ability to focus and causes increased anxiety. Anxious learners spend time worrying about what happens next, who might ask them a question, and so on. When properly set up, a classroom can be a haven for the anxious and/or visually distracted learner. Let's tame this barrier through design. You can design a classroom that is highly organized, free of visual distractions, and arranges furniture in a way that allows for individual space for all learners. One simple way to accomplish this is by using colored tape on the floor and through placement of furniture. Something so simple creates clear boundaries for learners, especially those with autism. When classrooms are set up this way, teachers can set up routines and expectations of the class easily due to the physical structure. Learners will always know where they are due to the design of the space and the use of colored tape or furniture placement. You can see in the examples that materials are also organized and that free access to everything and anything in these classrooms does not occur. Can you share a picture of your space that is visually distraction-free? Drop it in the comment below.